Good morning, Fox Pack. Welcome back to the Fox Den. Welcome back to the vlog, and welcome to another Acetry. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I am actually starting up a little detail business, so I'm really excited about that. If you're local and you're interested and want pro detailing for a good price, make sure you hit me up and we'll get you scheduled. But today, we have something in the mail that I'm quite excited about, so let's get into it. We have the Adams Polish Air Cannon. Now, this is the beast model, I guess you could say. This is the dual motor model, and the reason I got this is because if you've seen in the previous videos, we actually use this really big leaf blower. The problem with that is it uses fuel, it's very, very loud, and it's not particularly safe because it's not filtered air. So I decided, if you know, with the starting up my detail business, I'll grab one of these, and this was not cheap. So hopefully it'll be good quality, hopefully it'll work really good. I'm actually really, really excited to try this out, so let's get into it. Now, this will be a full review of this machine, along with setup and all that good stuff, so if you're interested in getting this for yourself, always cut toward yourself. No, don't do that. And this box was in another box. Three boxes. Excuse me, it's Adams Polishes, not Adams Polish. Now here's the actual box. That's what it looks like. And for some reason they show this end plugged into the machine. This is actually where you hold your tool. So I'm not sure why they got that reversed on the box, but whatever. See the foam grip, or it's not foam. It's like a koozie you put around your ice cold beer. Got our attachments. This attachment, this is good for grills and stuff like that. We have the machine itself. God, there's foam everywhere. And that's everything out of the box. Here's the machine. Take this plastic off. Now for $330, I was expecting this case to be metal. It's actually just plastic, so I'm a little bummed to see that it's got this cheap plastic around it. I was hoping that would be metal. It's not the end of the world, but for $330, I would have liked to have seen that to be a metal case. It's just plastic. But we do have the brakes on the casters. There's one there, and there's one there. So I'm very, very happy to see that. That's very nice to have if you're on a slope like I am, which you can't really see, but it is there, and it definitely is gonna help out with that. And I always like to see a very nice, long power cord. I'm not sure how long it is, but it looks pretty long. Because I'm always playing with extension cords out here, so it'll be nice to have that hopefully reach the outlet. I think it will. Got your on-off switch. It feels pretty nice. You got your speed selector. It's variable infinite speed, so you know it's not just low, medium, high. You can do it. You can set it to whatever you want. As I said, this is the dual motor model. Now, being that there's two big old motors in this thing, you definitely want to make sure you have a big enough circuit breaker to run this thing, because if you're putting this on a little dinky circuit breaker, chances are you're gonna blow it. This advertises heated air, but it's not actually heated. All it really is heat from the motors. It's really not gonna give you much heat, but who knows, maybe I'll be surprised. Let's have a look at the filter. Foam filter, there's, you know, it's not like a HEPA filter or anything like that, but you don't need that. You just wanna make sure you get, you know, the major debris out of the air that goes on your car. It appears there's actually a second filter in here. I don't know if you can see it. So let's go ahead and attach our hose. So in order to do that, it's very simple. All we have to do is get it lined up with the little notches in there. And then give it a turn, and our hose is attached. Line up the tabs and give it a turn, and there we go. All right, let's go ahead and plug it in. And the cord is decently long. Let's actually test and see how long this cord is. I would say that's probably about 10 feet, 10, 15 feet. Yeah, probably about 15 feet, I would say. Hard to say, but it's decently long. And let's fire it up, see how much power it's got. And also show you guys what it sounds like and all that good stuff. Now you watch when I turn this on, the hose will greatly expand, and we should be able to reach this all the way to the car. It's actually pretty quiet. See the hose expand. See if it'll grab the flag. Oh yeah. It's
got some power.
That'll definitely dry your car for sure.
Turn on minimum.
So minimum is a bit weak. I'm not sure where you would really use the minimum setting, but it is there if you want low powered air, which I guess is the whole point. Whoa, the crap out of the garage. You can see that hose retracts real nice. The hose is actually getting quite warm. So the air is actually getting heated, but it's nothing crazy, because once it comes out of the nozzle, it's really not that warm, but it does have some heat to it, so at least that's nice. It does have some pretty good power. It's definitely not as powerful as the leaf blower, but this will definitely get the car dry. And you can see this actually stretches all the way over there to the front of the car, so it does get quite long. So let's go ahead and actually get some water on the car, and let's see if we can dry it up. Now, I know this isn't soaking the car, but the car doesn't exactly need a wash right now, so it's actually quite a bit of water. Alright, so I had to record with the phone for a bit there because my camera died, which is just awesome. But this thing actually did a very good job. It's not as powerful as the leaf blower, but it did do a great job of drying all the water off the car. And obviously you're gonna need a little bit of patience. You know, it's not gonna dry instantly like the massive dryers at the automatic washes, but it definitely does really work. And the air actually does get pretty warm coming out of there. So I'm very pleased to say that the air does actually get warm. And there's no water left on the car. It's completely dry and it works awesome. Now, the results I would say would vary. It's definitely all gonna depend on if you have wax on your car or not. If you have wax on the car, your water is gonna bead up and it's gonna dry a lot easier. So if you are going to use this, you definitely wanna make sure you have wax on your car. But I would imagine anybody who purchases this product is gonna have wax on their car. So but yeah, that is definitely where it will work best. So yeah, definitely highly recommend it. Of course, I'll still have to wash the entire car, but honestly, I think it's safe to say it's gonna work very, very good. And I think I'll do a little update video when I do actually wash the entire car, so stay tuned. So that's gonna wrap up this review. Hope you enjoyed. And of course, very nice storage. We just stored it right down there next to the generator, and we just hung the hose right up here. So very easy storage, very easy to transport, and definitely, yeah, highly recommend it. It's worth the money for sure. You can get the cheaper ones, but they're not gonna be as powerful. They're not gonna last long. And I read the reviews on those, and there's just nothing but reviews of them failing. And yeah, so definitely pay the extra money. You could get like the Air Force Master Blaster. I looked into that, but that thing's really expensive. It claims it's 8 horsepower, one of them. And I'm sure it works really, really good, and I'm sure it's very powerful, but do you really need 8 horsepower motors out of this thing? This does the job. This is like 3.5 horsepower. I could be wrong. Make sure you check, but I know it's at least 3 horsepower. That's honestly, in my book, that's plenty of power. This thing is actually more powerful than the hose dryers at the manual car wash. It's actually way more powerful than those. So if I could dry it with those, I could definitely dry the car with this. So if you enjoyed this review, make sure you drop a like and subscribe. We have a lot of assetry on the way. We're gonna do some more videos on detailing. Once again, my detail business is officially open. If you're local and you want a pro detail for a good price, make sure you hit me up. I've been doing this for 7 years, so I found out what works, what doesn't. I promise you're gonna get really good results. So feel free to hit me up on Instagram if you're interested. Don't forget to subscribe, join the Fox Pack today. Hit the bell notifications to be notified when we do something stupid. Follow our racing club at Silver Fox Racing Group and me on Instagram at SilverFoxG37, so you can see all the behind the scenes of the assetry. And we now have a TikTok at Silver Fox Racing Group. Be sure to check it out. Remember, life is too short to stay stuck, and it's only legal if you get caught. Stay foxy.